video, we'll discuss the double declining balance method. We'll use this information to illustrate this method. This method is called an accelerated depreciation method because it results in more depreciation in the earlier years of an asset's life and less depreciation in the later years. The declining balance approach can be applied at different rates. The main method is the double declining balance, which uses a rate that is double or twice the straight line rate. The rate is applied to the book value. So the formula for the double declining depreciation is the book value at the beginning of the year times the rate. The straight line rate was 20%, so this rate is double or 40%. You could also take the useful life and divide in 2 to arrive at the 40%. Book value is the cost minus accumulated depreciation. Note that salvage value is not included in the formula. It is ignored until the last year. Book value for the first year is the cost of the asset. But in subsequent years, book value is the difference between cost and accumulated depreciation at the beginning of the year. The depreciation rate is 40%, which is double the straight line rate of 20%, or we can simply divide the useful life into 2. The depreciation expense is $5,200, and that is found by multiplying the book value of $13,000 by the rate of 40%. Accumulated depreciation increases, and the book value decreases by this amount. The journal entry in year 1 results in a debit to depreciation expense for $5,200 and a credit to accumulated depreciation for the same amount. Book value for the second year is $7,800. This is the difference between the cost of $13,000 and the accumulated depreciation at the beginning of the year, or $5,200. The depreciation rate is 40%, so the depreciation expense in year 2 is $3,120. This is found by multiplying the book value of $7,800 by the rate of 40%. Accumulated depreciation will increase by $3,120, and the book value will decrease by the same amount. This method calculates depreciation based on a declining book value. Annual depreciation expense is computed by multiplying the book value at the beginning of the year by the depreciation rate. The depreciation rate remains constant from year to year, but the book value to which the rate is applied declines each year. This method ignores salvage value when determining the annual depreciation expense, but salvage value limits the total depreciation that can be taken. Depreciation stops when the asset's book value equals its expected salvage value. In the last year of the asset's life, it is sometimes necessary to adjust the amount of depreciation expense so that the book value equals the expected salvage value. For example, note the adjustment of $685 in the last year. Just like with straight line, when an asset is purchased during the year, it is necessary to prorate the depreciation in the first year. If this company purchased the asset on April 1st, depreciation expense in the first year would be $3,900. And that is calculated by taking the annual expense of $5,200 and multiplying that by 9/12. The book value for calculating depreciation in the next year becomes $9,100, and that number is found by taking the cost of $13,000 and subtracting accumulated depreciation of $3,900. The depreciation expense is $3,640 in the second year, and that is found by taking the book value of $9,100 and multiplying that by 40%. In the last year, depreciation expense is $180, because that is the amount needed to arrive at total depreciation of $12,000.